One evening, when we had been sitting together for some time in companionable silence, she said, "You're lucky, Sarah. I mean, lucky to have your father. He's a good, kind, human man. It isn't easy to live with a saint. Father admires him tremendously." "Oh, so do I," declared Pam. "And I love him tremendously too, but his standard is too high for an ordinary, worldly mortal like me. That's the trouble." Chapter 22. It was September, and the Battle of Britain was at its height, when Lottie rang up and said she would come to lunch. "I suppose you can give me lunch," she said doubtfully. "Yes, of course, Lottie. It will be lovely to have you. I want to see you, Sarah. Yes, do come, Lottie." I felt quite excited at the prospect of seeing Lottie. I hadn't seen her since we left Fairfield. I'd asked her to come several times, but she'd said she was much too busy. Lottie arrived in a taxi at 1 o'clock. She was beautifully dressed, and her manners were sophisticated. "What a ghastly little den," she exclaimed when she saw the flat. "I don't know how you can bear to live in such cramped quarters." "I've got used to it," I replied. Compared with Riverside, it was a ghastly little den. Fortunately, she enjoyed her lunch. I had provided her favourite food. And afterwards, when we were having coffee together, she became more like herself and chattered happily about all she was doing. But she'd said she wanted to see me, and I'd received the impression that it was not just sisterly affection. So I asked if she was still quite happy with the Meldrums, or would she rather go to Craignethan?
"It would drive me raving mad to go to Craignethan," she replied. "Besides, I'm busy with war work.